4 years ago, we walked the halls as we now call fresh meat, counting down the years until graduation. Now here we are, counting down the days. As One Tree Hill's Nathan Scott once said, it's the oldest story in the world. One day you're 17 and planning for someday, and then quietly, without you ever really noticing, someday is today, and that someday is yesterday, and this is your life. When we were young, we couldn't wait to grow up. We couldn't wait to have a curfew or learn to drive. We never listened to our parents when they told us not to wish away our childhood and teenage years. Now here we are, senior year. I'll just admit it now. I should have listened. Soon it'll be time for me to go out and start doing things on my own. It'll be like learning to walk all over again, but this time there will be no one there to catch me if I fall. As I'm getting ready to move on in my life, there will be some life lessons I will be taking along as I begin this new chapter. Some being, selfishness is the root of most of today's world problems. Consider others when you consider yourself. Life does not revolve around your phone. You're able to put it down every now and then. Look around you. Don't take life for granted. Throughout high school, I have met so many amazing people that I'll never forget. Each person has taught me something, even the ones that didn't stay. My true friends accepted me for who I am and helped me through a lot, and for that I am forever thankful. Walking to PRP my freshman year, I was luckier than most freshmen walking in. I was practically raised in PRP, so with that, I've never had to worry about where my classes were or struggle to find someone I knew and trusted if I ever needed them. But don't get me wrong, I didn't just know everyone. I met teachers along the way who have impacted my life in countless ways. The major ones being Miss Bodie and Connie Spool. Miss Bodie, yeah, I know, most of you in this room don't like her. She's hard on you and comes off to be intimidating, but she's made the most impact on my life, hands down. Because of her class, she spiked my interest in psychology, and now in the fall, I'll be attending IUS as a psychology major. I grew up around Connie. She's been the biggest blessing, especially my time here at PRP. My grandma retired, she took me under her wing, and for that, I will forever be grateful. If I didn't feel good, her office was there. If I needed a rant, she was always willing to listen. She kept a drawer full of snacks when I was hungry and her fridge full of diet drinks and flavored waters. I can never thank her enough for everything she's done, not just the past 4 years, but beyond that. Sophomore year, I decided to try out for something no one had ever really talked to me about, the bowling team. Sounds lame, I know, but you can let me know when you find a team with 9 state championships and you're a part of the 2, which just happened to be back-to-back. Throughout this experience, I met some girls that changed me for the better. My best friend Sierra, Abby, and Kayla Payne. Although I have some of my best memories in high school, I'm not going to stand up here and pretend that it was everything I'd always imagined it to be, especially my senior year. Yeah, I was captain of the bowling team, in the dance choir, in the building club, rock for homecoming, and all that. However, I had to face the reality of life. Have you ever had that moment when you feel like all hope is gone? When you have to look deep inside yourself just to stay strong? You'll never realize how much you need a hero until you have to find it in yourself. Family has always been my number one priority. I am very close to my family, especially my grandparents. Throughout my junior year, my great-grandma Giddy Goat, as we all called her, she was in and out of hospitals. They told us it was UTI after UTI, which would take a lot out of someone who was 90. She would have really good days and then some not. As time progressed, her memory became worse and so was her balance. One day, I got the heartbreaking news after school. I will never forget the day. My mom always texted me saying she was going to be picking me up from school before practice, taking me to Chick-fil-A to eat before. She told me, after we got done eating, she sat me down and told me what the doctors had found. They finally found what was wrong with her. She had a brain tumor the size of a golf ball on the right side of her brain. The problem with that was they couldn't do surgery or anything because she was so old, there was way too many risks. The doctor said she might make it through the week, a month if we were lucky. From that day on, my mom and I practically lived in my grandma's house. Helped take care of my great-grandma. My schedule consisted of going to work during the day and helping with her at night during the summer. But during the school year, it was school, practice or game, homework, anything they needed before I went home, and then I'd go and help her. Although it was tiring, I wouldn't have changed it for anything. 2, 3, 4, 5 months go by. On a good day, she looked like her goofy self. I'm telling you all, you didn't know she was sick, you think nothing was wrong with her. But the 6 month approached, and October began, she slowly slipped into a coma. God blessed her with the wings on October 5th, 2016. Because of the support I was given at PRP, this made this depressing time much easier. I had teammates behind me 100%, and Ms. Gibson's class always there with a laugh. I never thought I'd meet someone I could trust anything with. I will never be able to thank Sierra for everything she's done. Not just during the rough days, but for being the person she is. I will never find a best friend like that ever again. So I was blessed to meet her. She and Cammy too. Lord knows I don't know what I'd do without my girls. Cam, thanks for always showing me those shopping gaps and telling stories at once that made me laugh until I cried. Shay, thanks for keeping my boyfriend in check and getting on butt when needed. Miss Goodson, oh girl. The first day of school I saw Jay in my schedule, I honestly didn't know what to expect. This year, in your class, I learned how to write paper in MLA format, how long you could keep using the same toothpick as you kept in your desk drawer, and how to count to 1,000 by counting how many times you scream, Malik, that's a charge, or night shift. To the rest of you, I know I'll talk to some of you, but thanks for making high school some of the best years of my life. Whether you're willing to admit it or not, you're going to do great things. Thanks.